Hi everybody, my name is Jens Larsen. I don't usually do videos purely on technique. I think I tend to focus more on what you're using your technique for, so how to play arpeggios and use different scales in your solos and play chord voicings. But with this exercise, I think maybe it really makes sense to just have a little bit of a closer look, because I think we're missing some of the things that we can learn from it and some of the ways that we practice it. So what this is really about is that if you think in a little bit of a different way and you focus on some other things, then you can drastically improve your technique. You can clean it up a lot, you can set yourself up to play a lot faster, and you're also working on thinking ahead. And those are all things that are extremely useful if you want to play jazz solos or if you want to, for instance, sight read something. The way I'm working with this exercise is really coming out of the way that I was taught when I had classical guitar lessons about 1.5 million years ago. And I think it's really curious that we're not approaching it like this when it comes to electric guitar and styles like jazz and rock, because I never see it discussed like this, and the focus is always on something else. If you want to learn more about jazz guitar, improve the way that you solo, check out some interesting arpeggios or chord voicings, then subscribe to my channel. If you want to make sure not to miss anything, then click the little bell notification icon next to the subscribe button. So the basic exercise I'm going to work with here is this sort of, it's not actually a chromatic exercise, but just this 1, 2, 3, 4 exercise. And of course you can do the same thing. The things I'm going to talk about is not really specific to this exercise. You kind of want to have that in all aspects of your playing, but it's a little bit easier to work with it like this, where you don't have to really worry about where you're playing the notes, and everything is easy for your right hand and stuff like that. The first aspect that I want you to incorporate into your technique practice is the idea of left hand preparation. So really that your left hand fingers are trying to move to the place where you need them next, ahead of when you actually need to play the note. Of course, you can't always do this, and it may seem a little bit counterintuitive that when we're improvising, we're trying to come up with stuff at the same time as we're playing it, but that's not entirely true. We're actually trying to play stuff that we already decided that we're going to play, that we already heard, or that we already know that we're going to play. So there is time to prepare, and you kind of want to have that in your technique. It's also something that's really going to help you and set up your technique if you want to improve your speed. For the exercise, so if we just have this sort of semi-chromatic exercise here, this means that when I'm playing the notes one by one, of course in the beginning there's nothing happening that you can really prepare, but once I'm playing this note, then my index finger should already be moving to the place where I need it next, and you can see how it's just ahead of what is going on. And that's of course just because I know that I'm going that way. And that can really clean up the sound. It's easier to just be a little bit ahead, so you don't have to sort of hit the string here and with the pick at the same time. That's the chances that it's gonna go well are a lot higher if the left hand finger is already in the right place. It gets even clearer if we play the descending version of this, so. So here what you can see is that I'm pretty much just putting down all the fingers in advance. And here you kind of also have the idea why I want to practice it on an exercise like this, where I don't have to worry about the notes at all. Everything is just like 4 notes per string, it's easy to play, and I'm not really too worried about which notes are in the scale or how do I play the arpeggio. Of course, once you have this, you can try and do something similar with, for instance, the scales. If I play a C major scale in this position, or an arpeggio. So you can see how it's really sort of setting up everything and keeping control, and my left hand has time to move in advance, so I might as well do it. And that's really what's going to help me play fast and also play more cleanly when I'm playing fast. The other thing that I think you should focus on and try to get into the way that you're playing your technical exercises is control of your fingers. And in one way of working with this is really to have a little bit of independence, but also just to try and see if you can keep your left hand fingers close to the strings all the time. And in the beginning, this is, at least for me, this was extremely annoying. I don't think that it's really a question of, it's very often explained as that you don't want to have to travel too far to get to the point where you need to go with the fingers. But I actually suspect that what we're trying to achieve here when we can do this is that we have some independence in the fingers and that it's easy to control them. Because if you have them sort of flying around, then you're losing control, and then that's the problem with the technique. It's not so much that your fingers have to travel far, that doesn't have to be a problem, really. So this is really just about gaining some control of the individual fingers and some finger independence. The way you work on this is, of course, just the same. So you play the exercise really slowly, trying to see if you can do, just staying really above the strings all the time, without having to sort of really force it. And in the beginning, for me at least, this was very frustrating to do, and it goes the same as with the other exercise. This is the kind of thing where, especially if you're doing just this type of exercise, which is in many ways just very mechanical, boring and unmusical, you do this once or twice and then you move on. So if you do this once or twice focusing on preparing, and then another one where you're trying to focus on just keeping your fingers just above the strings and really just having control of that, you can let go one by one. And it really, to me, it is about the control. It's not so much about whether you're doing this, really. It's just that you really have the control and that you can really decide where your finger is, because that's what you need to have good technique. In terms of developing the control and the independence of your left hand fingers, there are quite a few exercises. Again, this is stuff that I have out of the classical repertoire of exercises from when I had classical lessons. And this is something that I could return to in another video. And if it's something that you're interested in, then leave a comment on this video and let me know. Then that is definitely something I could make a video on. The reason I can keep on publishing videos every week is that I have a community of people over on Patreon that are supporting the channel. I'm very grateful for their support. And if you want to help me keep making videos, then check out my Patreon page. If you join us over on Patreon, I can also give you something in return for your support. If you want to check out some more videos with my ideas on how you should practice your scales and arpeggios and other technical things, then check out this playlist. I have a few videos in there that are all on that topic. If you want to learn more about jazz guitar and this is the first time you see one of my videos, then subscribe to my channel. And if you want to help me keep making videos, then check out my Patreon page. That's about it for this time. Thank you for watching, and until next week.